Welcome back, guys. This is Ibrahim Quraishi, and you're watching VMware Tutorial for Beginners. This is session 23, and we are going to continue the third session on VMware virtual networking. And in this session, we are going to add ESX host to a distributed virtual switch, which we recently created in the previous session. So let's get started. As always, I just wanted to remind you, I love your comments, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button. Alright then, let's get started. Agenda for today is distributed virtual switches, which we have used, that's a mouthful, and deployed in the previous session. And today, I am going to use the same distributed virtual switch and show you how to add a ESX host to it. Again, if you haven't seen the standard virtual switch session which I have done, you can always go back and check that. So we have covered the standard and distributed both. Just to remind you, the configuration of virtual distributed switch or distributed virtual switch is centralized to the vCenter server. So you only manage it when you create it, and then all the hosts are added to the same switch. So that's why there's no ambiguity. Obviously you don't need to individually create it, and as a result there's less overhead on the VMware administrator. And again, also distributed virtual switch does require you to have a higher level of license enabled on your environment. So let's get started for the demo then. So this is where we left the last lab, where we created a VM traffic VLAN 1000. Now to add this particular distributed virtual switch, what I need to do is right click and then select add and manage ESX host. When I click on that, of course this was newly created, so there isn't any host which are added there. You do get certain options, so if you can also choose to remove if it's already added to a to some host, and you can select remove and remove it. Okay, but today's demo we are going to add host, select that and then click next, and then there's nothing here. If you have already got some host, this is where you will see it. Because I haven't got anything, it's empty. So I'm going to add 103 and 104, which are my host in the demo cluster, as you can see here. Then click on OK. Click on Next. And then it's going to say what it's going to do. Look, selection adapted task. And choose to migrate the VM kernel. So I'm going to migrate the virtual machine network as well. So it has shown me VM kernel port group is there, and then the uplink is there, and then I'm going to add this virtual machines to the same uplink. And then I can select which switch I want to use. Click next. Just want to click next. So there's no impact to these two traffic. What you're moving. Now if you remember, guys, there was an error message. It was purely because one of my host has multiple NICs which I added, and the other one only had one, and it was complaining that obviously you're not having equal NICs, and I selected the uplink as vSwitch 0 anyway. So that's how you add this configuration, and once you added it, you will see the number of managed hosts for this distributed switch is 2. Click finish. So you can see these are added. In the host tab, you should be seeing to host. So that's how you do it, boys and girls, of course. Okay, so this was a quick demo of how we basically add a distributed virtual group, distributed virtual switch to your ESX. Add ESX host to your distributed virtual switch. It's the other way around, right? Okay, I hope you enjoyed watching this. Let's get back to our slides quickly before we end this session. Hope you like the demo. As I was saying, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button. Don't forget to reach out to me on Twitter. If you have any questions, stop using LinkedIn, please. That's for my professional side only. And you can follow me on my blog. My new website is launched recently, and it's agileops.co.uk. So have a look at that. And by now you should know what these are: SvSwitch and DvSwitch. Please comment on below and let me know. And let me know what is management traffic used for. I've been asking the same question so that you can get it right. And the next session we are going to do is going to cover all the traffics which we have on VMware. So stay tuned for the next session. Leave your comments below with your responses, and I'll give you a thumbs up if you got the right answer. Okay, guys, don't forget to subscribe, enjoy watching, and keep sharing. Cheers, bye.